Hello everyone, I am referencing the Psycho Babble Raps video that he basically brought up my name on his channel once again, and so I've decided, you know what, let's educate PBR after he made some comments saying, quote unquote, people who DoorDashes are unskilled. So, if you don't mind, we're going to switch this over, let you hear the comments, because he decided to indirectly bring up my name on his YouTube channel. We're going to address PBR on this video. So, let's play the audio, shall we? Well, let you also see what I'm talking about. All right, here we go.
Well, I'm in my retirement shop. Four tools. And where are you? Sitting in your boy's mobile home in the mobile home park. Zero skill. If you got off your lazy ass to go get a job tomorrow, you'd have to go like flip burgers or do DoorDash or do Uber or go to Walmart and stock chips. You have no skill set of any kind.
No skill set of any time. All right, let's cover something that you said. No skill set. Someone who can go up and look into records / private investigator, in which they're looking up information and looking up records or something else. Guess what? That's a skill, because they know where to look. They know how to drag up information. An investigator is a skill. Number two, and not everyone knows how to investigate stuff. Number two, someone who works in a call center. That's working on something termed as soft skills. Being able to do rapport. Now, what's rapport? Rapport is being able to communicate to a customer in order to get them to buy a product. Part of rapport is providing empathy, understanding the situation that they're on, and kind of like, you know what, I'm sorry about you having to go through that type of stuff. That is considered building empathy. Empathy is a skill. Speaking of cars, being a car salesman, requires that you build rapport. That's something very important here when we're going through what you're talking about. And being a DoorDasher, you have to build rapport with the customer when you're delivering food, because you're saying, hey, you know what, I'm at your home, I'm getting ready to walk up your door, and here's your food. And you know what, that in a way is also building rapport. Now, you've made comments in the past, and not just on YouTube, you've made comments in the past involving a website known as Blow Aces, where you said, quote unquote, professional wrestlers are unskilled. And you got to think about that. Because professional wrestlers have a physical skill. Because if they didn't have a physical skill, they would wind up getting hurt with each other. Be honest with you, I would love to see you catch a 400-pound man and keep him from busting his ass on a hit and getting a severe concussion. You know what? That's a skill. But a professional wrestler has to know how to sell, aka build rapport when they're behind the mic. Because believe it or not, you have to have mic skills in order to do it, and you got to be able to relate to the character so the people who's watching TV can understand the storyline that they're telling. Because believe it or not, professional wrestlers are storytellers. And there's a reason why I'm bringing up professional wrestler. Because I can actually provide you a link that there's a professional wrestler who's in WWE right now, who has done DoorDash. And he's done Uber. And that's none other than, get this, current Judgment Day member, J.D. McDonough, who has come out and said, you know what? I was actually going out door dashing. And since the fact that you're attacking somebody who's quote unquote an actor, it's really funny because of the simple fact that it wasn't just J.D. McDonough who's done it. But there's another former WWE superstar who was an NFL superstar at one time, better known as Top Dollar, and I don't remember his name off the top of my head, but his name was Top Dollar, who is part of Hit Row, who was also doing either door dashing or Uber in order to make money. So for you to sit here and say, quote unquote, door dashing is unskilled, that's not necessarily true. Now, PBR, let's go on a bit further with this comment about you talking, you're sitting here knocking down people who flips burgers at McDonald's, and at the same time, people who has done other materials of you saying that, quote-unquote, they're door dashing. let's hit this off with another name. Because if you're saying a professional wrestler who has done DoorDash and Uber is unskilled, then you might as well say that a actor on television who is telling a story is also unskilled, which is also far from the truth. Because there are two people that at one time here on YouTube was number one most subscribed individual on YouTube. One's no longer dead, and the other one just doesn't want to do YouTube videos. And that is none other than Lisa Nova and Little Loca, who you're also calling unskilled. In reality, they're just like a professional wrestler. You get my point, what I'm trying to get at here about you going around saying that someone is unskilled when in reality that's not the case. And yeah, you're going after Wade with your video, but you had to cut your short, put in your two cents about calling DoorDashers and people who drives for Uber as being unskilled. You had to go that route, didn't you? And you even went in this very same video saying that, quote unquote, a mechanic doesn't have to have a diploma. At one time, that statement used to be true. But Congress has made changes which requires mechanics to have high school diploma. And it all depends on the type of business or the person to whom owns that business on whether or not someone has a degree or not, a diploma or not, I should say. In fact, in some states, to be a mechanic, you have to have a high school diploma. So the statement that you sat here and saying that, quote unquote, being a mechanic doesn't require an education, that is not necessarily true. In your state, it may not be required. But if you go in states like Missouri, you go in states in Illinois, you go into states like Texas or Nevada or California or whatever, it requires that you have some formal training. And in some states, they do require a high school diploma now. So you're saying, your statement on YouTube is also incorrect. Yeah. So let me make something very perfectly clear. Having soft skills having soft skills is a skill. Having hard skills, like being a mechanic, has a skill. But by your own definition, and let me make something perfectly clear of something that you said. Your definition on someone who is unskilled is someone who doesn't have a high school diploma. And in itself, doesn't have a life. Well, by your own definition, and has no formal training to do something, is considered unskilled. Being a dropout out of high school and learning how to become a mechanic can be considered, in your own definition, as being unskilled. Because it doesn't require a high school diploma. And you said, quote unquote, that you went years and years and years and years of education just before you can become a mechanic. And that's not necessarily true either. Because by your definition of what you said, you have on the job training, which meant you had a mentor in order to work on cars. And you even mentioned that mentor in your video. Working in a call center, you have to be trained how to sell materials. And sometimes, depending on the call center, you could be sitting in a classroom for 3 weeks before you're walked out on the floor. And guess what? When you're on that phone, it's the same thing as being a mechanic, because you're being trained while on the job. And let's also address something that you said. About being a mechanic. Working in a production industry and working in a mailroom, like I have, if you don't jog your papers well enough, then you're going to wind up having something called a miss or a double. Why? Because air gets in between the two papers. And that's what causes a lot of times misses and doubles. And you know what? If that machine lights up like a Christmas tree, because you're missing and you're doubling all the time, guess what? How do you get that machine to work without those lights going off? It takes some skill. It takes a lot of work in order to make sure that that machine doesn't light up like a Christmas tree. But by your own definition, you yourself have said that you are unskilled. Do I think you're unskilled? No. But by your own standards and by your own words, with what you have said, you have defined yourself as being unskilled. Like I said, the funniest thing about judging others it kind of gets you into a situation that you've also judged yourself. That's why judging others is not necessarily smart, PBR. Have a nice day.